Welcome. In this video, I'm going to talk about doing batch conversion of legacy files on the command line using LibreOffice. So what I have here are CWK files, which would be Clarisworks or Appleworks. And that was an integrated office suite that was popular on the Mac back in the day. So I have a bunch of files. I have 10 files here in a directory, and I want to batch convert these. So right now it's hard to even open them with anything. Some will open with, these are spreadsheets and word processors. The spreadsheets seem to open with Excel, but the word processor, I couldn't get them to open with anything. Well, I could get them to open with LibreOffice, and that's the tool I'm going to use to convert all of these. So instead of opening each one into LibreOffice and choosing Save As, we can do it on the command line a lot faster. Now I have 10 files here, but imagine you had 100 or 1,000 files. So what you want to do first is I'm in the directory, this CWK2 directory, which is, you'll see here, and I can type in find space and then ./ and then space dash name space and then a single quote and then *.CWK, which is the extension. And these are all lowercase. If you had some uppercase ones, then you could say iName here, which would make it case insensitive. So I'll just add iName in here. It won't hurt anything. So once we do that, we can hit enter, and then this will show us all of the CWK files, which we can see on the screen here. But if you had, 100 of them, you could look at the list before you convert. So we'll go back up to the find command. And if you don't know command line, you can push the up arrow to go to the last command you were at. And then we'll type space, and then we'll type execdir. So exec is when you want to execute a command. When you say execdir, it runs a command from within the any folders. So when we convert these, it will place a new copy, the converted file, in the same folder as the original. If we just went with exec, it would put the files in whatever folder we're in right now. Like you see this budget 1998, it would place the converted copy in the parent directory because that's where we are. So we wanted to use this execdir, and then we'll do space, and then I'll do /// applications, and then /// LibreOffice, LibreOffice.app. So you can see exactly what's being typed in here. I'm using tab completion, so I just start typing it, hit tab, and it finishes it for me. And then we want to go to contents, and then macOS, and then SOffice. So it's called SOffice because LibreOffice originated as StarOffice. So there used to be some software called StarOffice that became OpenOffice and then LibreOffice, but the command line still goes by SOffice. Next, you want to type space and then --/ headless. This means don't open it each time, the graphical interface. Then we want to type space and then --/ convert-2 and then a space. And I want to say DOCX. So this is going to convert it to Microsoft Word Docx format type. And then I want to type space and then --/ outdir space ./ space and then left brace right brace space and then --/ semicolon. So we have the command here and we will run this. Okay, so that's finished. Now if we look back at our data here, you'll see there's this answerKey.CWK and there's no converted version of that. And then we have article.CWK and there is a converted version. So, and you'll notice through here, some are converted, some aren't. So what I found was really cool with this is that, let me clear my screen here and get back up to that command. We were converting the CWK to Docx. Well, that is looking, well, Docx is a word processor and some of these are spreadsheets and it uses the same extension for the word processor and the spreadsheet with Appleworks or Clarisworks. So it knew which one it was and only converted it if it matched. So we can go back here and change this to say convert to Xlsx and then run this again. And this should convert anything that was a spreadsheet. So you have to run this twice if you have some docs, some word processor files and some spreadsheet files. So we'll run this here. Okay, so now if we go back into our files here, we'll see that they all have a match here. So they were either a word processor or a spreadsheet. That's the conversion process. Now I would open these and show them to you, but this is not my data, so I don't feel at liberty to share with people. I actually changed the names of these files. So these were personal files, but I changed the name. But you can see the conversion happened and these do open. So I have tested some of them. Now if you wanted to delete the original files, I mean right now it has both, and that's probably the safe thing to do. But if you checked all these out and they all look good and you want to get rid of the original ones. Then we want to run another command. We want to type find space dash forward slash space dash iname space quote star dot CWK quote. And then we can run this to make sure it has the list we want. And then we'll type space dash exec space RM space and then left brace, right brace space backslash semicolon. And if we run this, it will delete them. And this is, you can really screw up your system doing this. So if you don't feel comfortable doing it this way, then you might want to manually delete them or find some other method. But you know, if you type the wrong thing on your find command, just be careful. It's always good to look at what you're running on the find command before you put this exec stuff in here. So if we run that, it deletes everything. So now all we have here are the original files. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.